What's up, y'all? My name is Hannah. This is Banana Brains, and my jaw is in a lot of pain. So if it sounds like my pronunciation is squished, it's because I just got my wisdom teeth taken out and my cheeks hurt. I'm trying not to move my mouth a whole lot. So let me share a quick passage with you. This is from Job chapter 11, verses 13 through 19. If you prepare your heart, you will stretch out your hands toward him. If iniquity is in your hand, put it far away, and let not injustice dwell in your tents. Surely then you will be lifted up, and your face will be without blemish. You will be secure and fear nothing. You'll forget your misery. You'll remember it just like waters that have passed away. And your life will be brighter than the noonday sun. Even its darkness will be like the morning. You'll feel secure because there is hope. You'll look around and rest in security. You'll lie down and nothing will make you afraid. For many will court of your favor. That sounds pretty lit. I don't know about y'all, but that life sounds pretty awesome, right? Can I say that this is wrong? Can I say that the Bible is wrong? Huh? Like what? How is the Bible wrong? If something's in the Bible, it has to be right, right? No. Let's go over a few points here. Just because something is in the Bible doesn't mean it's commendable. First, I want to talk about how context is king. Second, how righteousness does not guarantee a perfect life. And third, how dangerous it is to put words in God's mouth. So context is king. Here is why you always have to be skeptical when you read anything, even the Bible. You always need to ask, yes, what is being said here, but who is it being said by? Why is it being said? And is this something that I should follow? Or is this an example that I don't want to follow? The guy who is saying all of this, his name is Zophar. And he's one of Job's friends. And he's not a very good friend because just a few verses back, he actually tells Job that God thinks really lowly of him. And Zophar tells him that Job deserves much worse than he's suffering. And if you don't know who Job is, he's a guy who lived way, way, way in the olden times. He got everything stripped away from him, his whole family, all of his wealth, all his riches, his servants, all his property. He lost everything. His health went to shambles. He got super sick and his life was horrible. And it was pretty much a bet between God and Satan. And Satan wanted to test Job to prove that Satan could turn anyone against God as long as he could bring them pain. And God knew that Job was not going to turn against God. So that's kind of who Job is if you've never read it. So anyway, back to the context. Zophar is not someone we want to listen to. Even though what he's saying is recorded in the Bible, he's not a guy we want to take advice from. And he's certainly not speaking things that are biblically true. This is what happens when humans try to explain things through their own understanding. Many of y'all have heard of the verse Proverbs 3:5 that says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding." That's really important right here. Zophar is pushing this notion that righteousness will be followed exclusively by peace and no fear and security and shiny lights and favor. And all of that is great, but it's nothing but a destructive, empty promise. The Bible says nowhere that just because we are righteous and we follow God's ways and, you know, we trust in the Lord, that our life is going to be perfect. So all these things that Zophar is preaching is pretty false. Which leads me to the next point of putting words in God's mouth. That's a big no-no. So I want to go over some dangers of leaning on your own understanding and trying to draw conclusions about circumstances that are happening in the world based on your own perspective instead of seeking the guidance and the perspective of the Holy Spirit. So when you try to come up with your own way of explaining things, or you're trying to say, oh, God must think this, or maybe God is doing this because of this, or maybe this is happening, you know, because you did this or whatever. There's a lot of fallacies that come into play there. One, you're very likely to be spreading false doctrine, just like this guy Zophar is. He's spreading this false doctrine of if you do the right thing, your life is going to be easy. That's straight up lies. Okay, this can also be very damaging to someone's faith, especially if someone is a young believer and they don't understand. They're going to believe anything you tell them, as long as you tell them, oh, the Bible says this somewhere. Okay, that can be really damaging to someone's faith. You can lead someone astray or even into sinful paths because what you're saying is incorrect. And it also, it assumes that your ability to decipher is superior to the Holy Spirit or that of the Bible's conclusions. Okay, we don't always have to have answers to everything. One thing that I wrote down in my notes here was that perspective is a privilege. It's not a right. We don't have to have the right of understanding why things are happening. And Job, in the previous chapter, he's really kind of lashing out. And he just lets it all out. And he's saying, like, why, God? Why is this happening? You know, let me know why you contend against me. You know, why am I being punished? Who hasn't asked that question? Who hasn't asked God that before? Like, why me? Or why is this happening? Yet we can't hold out our obedience until we have just the right conditions of understanding. That's not how it works. You can't say, oh God, if you show me why, or if you help me understand this, then I'll obey you. Then I'll trust you. No, it doesn't work like that. He wants our obedience and he wants our trust, even when we can't see what's in front of us. That makes us lean on him instead of our own understanding. So just some rambles for today. Maybe these thoughts have been useful. And these aren't like conclusive. It's just sort of food for thought. Get you thinking a little bit, maybe inspire you to look at the word a little deeper and to be skeptical when you hear somebody quoting scripture and you're like, but who's actually saying that? What's the context around that scripture? What does that actually mean?